Okay, then you crossed the border from Canada into United States.
Well, actually, first I went to Vancouver Island. In Vancouver, we met. He couldn't stand being alone, and he said, I'm gonna go for a short trip to Vancouver. So we meet for, he flew to Vancouver. We met in Vancouver for 3 or 4 days, I think it was.
Oh, very good.
Yeah.
Very romantic guy.
It is, yes. And
Vancouver is a nice, really nice town. And so I always thought to visit once Vancouver, and that was a good idea. She was in Vancouver, I have time. So we met in Vancouver and had really nice days.
And then you went back to Germany.
Yes, I had to, okay. Because I have to work.
You have to work. By the way, I did mention, but they are police officers in Germany. I forgot if I told you that or not. And we'll talk about that a little later on too. Okay, so you're in Vancouver, you both meet, and then what happens after that?
Then after that we had to depart again. So I went to Vancouver Island, and I had a look at Vancouver Island, and I took the ferry from Victoria, which is in the south part of Vancouver Island, to Port Angeles, I think it's called.
Port
That's
Angeles.
Already United States.
Right.
So I took that ferry, and from then on, I did the, as they always refer to in Alaska, the lower states. I did.
Yes, the lower states.
Yeah. I did Washington. I went, I did zigzag there too, because I wanted to see all those national parks.
You went to like Yellowstone National Park?
Yeah. Well, how's it called? Glacier National Park
as
well?
Glacier National Park,
right.
Yes.
And Yellowstone, and I did have a closer look to Mount St. Helen, which is really impressive for me as well.
A big volcano.
Yes, and I hiked around there, and I did a helicopter trip as well to see the volcano from the top. And then I went down, I saw the redwoods.
Mm-hmm.
Which
those
is,
are giant trees.
You know, I thought, should I do the big trees? Well, big deal. One tree is little, the other one is big, so there's nothing really special about it. But when you stand beneath those trees, that is amazing.
Yes.
And I'm really glad I did that.
Yeah, those don't exist in other, very rare in other parts of the world.
No, I think that's the only part, to be honest. They are tremendous. I don't know what it is in feet, but they said the highest one would be 115 meters, which is incredible.
Yes.
That is
very
so
tall.
High.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, and then where did you go after that? After the redwoods?
Let me see. After the redwoods, I went. Where did I go?
Well, you went to part of some towns in Northern California.
Yes.
Right.
Northern California. Well, I did do some in Oregon as well.
Okay.
And I don't remember. Yellowstone, Yosemite. I went to Lassen National Park.
Okay, and then you did something very dangerous. That ordinarily we don't do on a motorcycle, only in a car, and that's you went through Death Valley in the middle of the summer on a motorcycle.
Yeah, well, so, several people told me that was a really stupid thing to do, and they told me before, and I did it anyway, so it was my own fault. Yeah, but I somehow needed to get to Las Vegas where we both met again, so. I had to find a way to go through there, and I wanted to see the Death Valley. I knew it was a bad time, but you know, it's my only time to be here, so it was rather see the Death Valley or never see the Death Valley, so I wanted to see it. I did it, but I have to admit, it was scary. It was getting hotter and hotter, I was getting deeper and deeper, and you know, it was scary. I was happy when I went out again.
Good, good. Okay, so then you went to Las Vegas. Why were you going to Las Vegas?
There were several reasons actually to go to Las Vegas. First one was we had to import his bike as well.
Okay.
And that was a very good airport to import a bike. It was cheap, it was good to reach.
You mean your bicycle was imported from Germany all the way to Las Vegas?
Yes.
Yes.
By airplane?
Yes. The same than Julius did in Anchorage. I put my bike on the aircraft in several days before I arrived in Las Vegas, and we flew to Las Vegas, and so we could drive with two bikes the rest of the trip.
Okay, and how do you transport a motorcycle on a airplane? Do you have to build a special container for a cage?
We are lucky because we had a friend of us. He knows someone who sells motorbikes, and all the motorbikes when they come over from Japan all over the world, they are done in a box, in an aluminium box, and we got one of them because it's a kind of trash. They threw it away, and we could get one, and so we put on the motorbike in this box and float to America.